Folks, this is Takisa coming back to you with another review, and today we're going to be doing another classic style review. Why? Because I am rushing and getting ready for work. So I figured, you know what, why not do a video right before I get ready for work? That's how it goes, right? You gotta multitask nowadays. That's just the way it is in the 21st century. Let's go ahead and get into this right here and let's get started. So today we're going to be getting into a pair of shoes that I got almost 2 months ago, but just honestly did not have the time to review. But I figured, you know what, y'all haven't seen these on the channel yet, let me go ahead and bring them to you real quick. So first off, let's go ahead and look at the box. We got the Ashy Box on deck, 1985 Air Jordan 1 box. Okay, here's the colors right here. Y'all can pretty much tell what we're going to be reviewing just based on the colors. But now here's the interesting part here. It says here that the retail is going to be $130 on these. I doubt it's going to be that low for these, what I'm about to show y'all. But hey, you know what? I've seen stranger things with Nike releases. So who knows? We got the top of the box here. No stamp. The Air Jordan 1 paper. We got the shoe horns or the shoe trees. And the laces right here. Come on now, y'all don't know what these are? Y'all don't know what these are yet? Y'all haven't guessed it yet? Okay, all right. We got the anti-mold sticker right here, so no problems with that. But let's go ahead and get into the shoe itself, which we are talking about today. That's right. Let's bring it closer into frame. The Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG Pollens, or the Wu-Tang 2.0's is what I call them. Wu-Tang on deck all day. Definitely for the babies, definitely for the children. But you know what? It's not an official Wu-Tang shoe release, so we'll leave it at that. But come on now, just look at the color scheme. Look at the upper, look at the toe box, the mud guard, the quarter panels, the swoosh, the heel, the ankle. Like, these ain't Wu-Tangs right here. Look at this outsole right here. Look at that, look at that. Star prominent on them. Outsole, got the Nike right here, nice and clear. These ain't the Wu-Tangs right here. Come on, the name Pollen, for goodness sake, Pollen. Like, come on now. Just look at those up close. These ain't the Wu-Tang 2.0s. Whatever, man, that's what we call them on this channel, the Wu-Tang 2.0s. Look at that nice print on the Air Jordan. Look at that, beautiful, beautiful. But let's put these right here right quick. You know I like to educate before I go further into the review. So, as we know, the Jordan brand mainstay gets styled with a bumblebee-esque theme. Bumblebee, killer bees on the swarm. Okay, whatever, whatever. Michael Jordan's signature footwear line is packed with a number of cultural shifting silhouettes, but if one were to boil it down to the model that tends to generate the most excitement, it would be these right here, the Air Jordan 1s. Now, this is especially true for its popular retro high OG model, which has this pollen makeup ready to launch towards the latter half of the year. Revealed recently throughout the year, earlier throughout the year, these were revealed. The makeup is mainly reliant on a duo of tones to make up for its base layer. Its titular tone is responsible for dyeing areas such as the overlays, lace, and swooshes, while black paint is distributed to the toe boxes, as we were talking about right here. Quarter paneling, as we were talking about before, on the lateral and on the medial side. And the collars, which we see right on the top section here, right? Cool. The former is crafted with smoother leathers, while the latter is engineered with tumbled textures. What they're talking about here, we got your tumbled right here on the quarter panels, which, matter of fact, hold on a second. I'll just get that light on so we can see what we're talking about. Got the tumbled leather right here on deck. Tumbled leather on the toe box. Y'all can see here. Smooth, nice. Let's check this side here. We're looking at the right shoe first before the left. Alright, so putting that down right here. Hope you're having a good day today. Excuse me for clearing my throat on the on the microphone here. So we were talking about the toe boxes, the quarter panels, the collars, the smoother leathers, ladders engineered with tumbled textures. If you took a look at a subtle pinch of white, also makes its presence felt on top of the tongue. So they're just talking about right here, as y'all can see on the Nike Air. That's what's up. Through its Nike Air branding, and given the nature of this pair's color blocking, many are drawing comparisons to the ever-popular Wu-Tang Dunk that you see on the screen that was released in 1999. Bottom pieces string together its entire look with angelic midsoles and pollen color shredding. Angelic being just white all across the midsole. Now, Nike Sneakers has not announced the release date on these just yet, but reports have these slated to drop August 21st at $470. That's why I was like, $130 in that box? Yeah, I don't think so. Maybe for a mid, maybe for a dunk, but never for a Jordan 1 retro. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the right side, or excuse me, the left side shoe. As you can see again here, the Nike Air on deck, that's what's up. Got the inside right here, made in China as it normally is. We got our Nike Air. Let's take a look at the tag right quick. We're gonna pause it. Cool. Yep, Nike Air on the insignia, on the insole right here. Thoughts about the shoe overall? Well, put it right here for a second and bring this up. I think Nike is doing what they need to do to make sure that people stay engaged with the Air Jordan 1s. I mean, that's really all I can say about that. They keep coming out with basically colorway after colorway after colorway. You know, and one thing about it, it really helps to push that brand even more so. Because yeah, I mean, Air Jordan 1 may not be the most comfortable shoe compared to the Air Jordan 2s, the 4s, the Air Jordan 11s. Those are actually quite comfortable. But these are always going to be the most nostalgic. And no matter what people can say about this particular shoe, which we'll put this one right here for a second. Sorry for the shaky cam. If it wasn't for these, all the other ones wouldn't exist. If this didn't hit back in 1985, y'all can argue me down about this, but let's keep it a buck. These, if they didn't exist and they didn't hit, people weren't feeling them. 2 would never have been created. 3 was never going to be created. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14, and yada yada after that. But 1 through 13, which are more of the more popular retro silhouettes, never would have been created. So you know what, I'm gonna say this, I'm glad that I got these pair gifted to me so I could go ahead and review these for y'all. Sorry it took so long, but hey, life goes on, things come up from time to time. So I appreciate y'all coming on board to see this review, looking at some information with me, or you know, allowing me to share some information with you about this shoe. As y'all can see, everything looks good on these shoes. Let's go ahead with it. Let me stop shaking this camera if I could. We have our lateral side right here. We have the medial side right here. The front of the shoe right here. I'll show y'all the slope. Nice. We got the back. So hourglass on deck on the left. Hourglass on deck for the right. Now you might be thinking, Taikisa, why is it taking you so long to do the review on these, but now all of a sudden you're rushing it? Oh, that's because I'm putting these on feet today. Yep. Ain't gonna sit there and lie. Yep, matter of fact, because like I said, I'm trying to get ready for work, so let's go ahead and wrap this up now. So we are just looking at here the Air Jordan 1 Retro High OG Pollens of Wu-Tang 2.0's. As y'all can hear the Wu-Tang music on deck, you know, I don't care about losing the monetary value because, hey, I'm just trying to show y'all the shoe. And at the end of the day, it's about the love of the shoe from me to you, as you see on camera here. Folks, this is Taikisa. If you have any questions, concerns, please make sure to hit me up on Instagram. Information right there on the screen, as you can see. More than happy to answer any questions or concerns as I can. So bear with me. Be patient. I got y'all. But please, let's go ahead and get onto his own feet so we can keep it moving. Thanks for watching. Y'all take care of yourselves, and I'll see you on the next one.